Yo guys, what is going on? Future DeSexton back again. I'm not gonna give an intro because there is actually an intro, but I do just have to mention that my technology and my everything that I own hates me and is actually out to kill me. It is bullying me, and everything that I own, whether it's my Xbox, my DS, or my computer, it wants me to kill myself. So leave a like if you want to end the war on technology trying to bully kids. So what I'm trying to say is that my video and audio unsynced itself, so there won't actually be the video to the voice of me. My face cam won't be in this. It will actually just be the gameplay. But you will still hear me, just I won't be there. So also leave a like if you're up for not seeing my face for the first like 10 minutes of the video. But other than that, guys, spoilers are coming in 3, 2, 1.
Alright guys, we are getting into day 10 right now. This is coming down to the wire. We have it says here we have 27 battles down so far, so we have 18 battles to go. We are gonna get the last three battles of the day two done today, and so after that we're on a highway to hell to the end. I'm seeing freaking Snorlax again, and this is big. This is huge. I want to prepare for the Snorlax, but then again, I can't over prepare for the Snorlax. I feel like Muk and Incineroar have to come. They're gonna be huge opponents to my opponent here. Huge components to my team. There we go. That's what I'm trying to say. But then I think we're gonna need to bring Zerk could be very useful. And I believe Celesteela could be useful. I think I'm gonna lead Muk and Incineroar. I don't see too much of a threat right off the bat. I won't lead Incineroar. I think I'm gonna lead Celesteela for at least a little bit of ground coverage. And then I think I need to bring this is going to be bad. I am bringing Incineroar. And I think Zerk does work here. I'm just going to go ahead and bring Zerk. That could be a huge mistake on my part. If he brings Salazzle, we could be in trouble. For some reason, I was thinking it was on a psychic attack. We could be in trouble right here. I don't want to over-prepare for the Snorlax. I think Fiery MZ and Muk can take care of that. But we are gonna see a Salazzle Snorlax lead, so he's gonna get a Toxic off, it looks like. Toxic Snorlax, then Venushock, Salazzle. So my problem is that Salazzle can Toxic anybody, kind of confused here. I don't know. But I think I can, if I poison jab into, I need to get the kill on Salazzle. No, I'm not making that mistake again. I am going to set up, I am going to switch out Celesteela into, I don't want to do that. I think I'll leave Celesteela in. And I don't have time, so I'm just gonna set up the iron defense. Could have been a big mistake. He's gonna fake out the Muk. That was the only thing I attacked with that turn. And I see a belly drum coming. If he belly drums, this is gonna be really, really bad. He's gonna curse, so that's fine. I say that's fine, but I just think of it as it's not belly drum. He's gonna get the attack raise. At least it's not six attack raises. I think I want a Stone Edge into Salazzle. And then I think I can be safe to switch out into Incineroar. Hopefully, expecting a fire move to come in. And I want to get the I want to get a Fire EMZ off into Snorlax before he bulks up too much. If he gets too bulky, we may have a problem. I'm gonna bring in Celesteela or bring out Celesteela and bring in Incineroar. We're gonna take something here. We're gonna take a flamethrower, looks like into Incineroar. We're gonna eat that up pretty nicely. We are gonna get the Stone Edge into Salazzle. If that's not sashed, we should get the kill, and it looks like we don't. And we are gonna take a double edge into the Muk slot. And Muk almost goes down. And you couldn't give me a nice little poison touch poison right there. So I think my best bet is to Shadow Sneak the Salazzle. And I'm gonna drop this big boy Fire EMZ into Snorlax here. And hopefully do a good amount of damage. I think I can still come in. If he has Lele, I think I could come in with Celesteela and take out Lele. The Salazzle is a big problem with when it comes to Celesteela. But we are taking a long time, and after the last game, it's still the same day. He's gonna withdraw Salazzle, so he's still gonna get another fake out to come in. We're gonna get a Shadow Sneak onto Machamp. Snorlax is gonna protect, but we're still gonna get that Fire EMZ off. Hopefully this doesn't do enough damage. This is still gonna hit Snorlax. It's probably not gonna do much. I didn't really expect a protect from him, but that was a really good move on his part, saving the Salazzle, because he can still come in and fake out Muk and get the kill. But we're gonna see what this Fire EMZ on a protect does. Please do damage. Did it move? Did it even move? I'm really scared right now. I'm really scared. I could expect a Mach Putt punch to come in, or a Stone Edge, or anything else. I think I can be okay with sacking off Muk. I could get a Shadow Sneak into Machamp, get some extra damage going. And then I could even, I don't know, I feel like I have to get work done on Snorlax. I don't want to get walled by another Snorlax right now. If I get walled by him, I can be in big trouble. I ran out of time. I kind of wanted to go Earthquake. We are gonna get a free Shadow Sneak off. Muk will go down this turn, regardless. We are gonna take a Dynamic Punch into Incineroar. That's probably gonna be Incineroar down. It is Incineroar down. So at this point, we bring in Celesteela and Zerk. And my only move is to dis is to Dazzling Gleam, and if Snorlax has any recovery moves, like Rest, then we could get walled right here. And he still has a fourth Pokemon that we don't really know what it is. But if I had Air Slash right now, which sadly we don't have, I would feel a lot safer. But my best bet is to just start Dazzling Gleaming. And if I pick up a kill, we can probably start really chipping away at Snorlax with a Beast Boost. So I'm gonna Dazzling Gleam, and this could hopefully pick up the kill on Machamp. I could Giga Drain into Snorlax, hopefully get some extra damage back. Which I think that's what I'm gonna do. We still have to take a fake out regardless of whoever comes in right now. But if he switches in Salazzle at any point, just thinking he can get a free switch in. Dazzling Gleam will pick up the kill on that Salazzle because he's at sash health right now and he's not gonna take a switch in. He's gonna protect the Machamp. Which is fine. He's gonna see what we do, though. We are gonna get a Dazzling Gleam off. Really ready to see what this does. Okay, that does a lot more than I thought it would. He is gonna get a Citrus. I know he's probably Figgy Berry. Gluttony Figgy Berry. Yeah. We are gonna get a Giga Drain into Snorlax. We are at full health, so I don't think that does much. We're gonna take a Double Edge into Zerk, and that kills Zerk. We aren't gonna make it out of this, guys. We can't make it out of this right now. We got walled by another freaking Snorlax. My best bet is to go into Machamp. If I can take out Machamp, I just need to. He's got. Just enjoy the conversation from my family out of the room while I take this in. Hey guys, that puts us at 11 and 18, which is just, exactly where I want to be. There is a mess up on the standings right now, the win loss. That I'm gonna have to think about. So ignore the 11-18. I will fix it. You'll hear the right standings for the next battle. But we gotta look at this. We have another stupid Salazzle. We have a Scizor coming in. Triple dragons. I could see a triple dragon team and expect he'll lead with a Glaceon and expecting me to bring a dragon. Really. What I could do is I could lead Slowking. I definitely need to bring Slowking. If I can get a Trick Room off, that'd be really nice. I am gonna bring Zerk because he's gonna be very viable to me here. And I want to bring Muk, but then again, what does that really do? It doesn't really do much for him. Besides, I get priority. I want to bring Celesteela again, but I feel like I need Trompa as well to kind of break through this. I'm gonna go with the hopes that God, I need to bring Trompa. I am actually gonna bring Trompa. Trompa will be my earthquake switch in. But as I was saying, the standings are screwed up somehow. Because right now, what I'm looking at is that I think I'm 11 and 18, but it's only saying I have 28 battles, so I do have to look at that and fix that first, or after this battle, I will look for it. He is gonna lead Scizor, which the only thing I have a threat of is like a X Scizor maybe, or just a bug move in general. I am really scared about this right now. I think I'm gonna Ice Beam into Dragonite. And I feel like I'll just stay in, and if I lose, I think I'm gonna save Zerk, because I don't wanna take a outrage or anything. We are gonna bring Muk. I kind of felt like we brought Celesteela, but I forget things pretty easily. So we are gonna switch into Muk, actually. So neither of these guys want to take a bug move right now. Dragonite's gonna get a Dragon Claw into Slowking. We will actually eat that up. I probably could have stayed in. We're gonna take a Fury Cutter, and we're gonna barely live that. We're gonna get an Ice Beam off into Dragonite, and it's not gonna do anything. And he's gonna get Is that no, we I didn't see that. But we are gonna get some Shell Bell back. We're not taking anything right now. I couldn't just expect a Dragon Claw into Muk. Because I don't think he's gonna double down into Slowking again. So I'm actually gonna go into Drompa, hopefully expecting he doesn't Dragon Claw into Drompa, because that could be huge. And I think I can Stone Edge into Dragonite. We are gonna get this. We're gonna switch into Drompa here. If he Dragon Claws into Muk, I'm okay with that. He's just gonna Earthquake, and that could be Muk down right there. We're just gonna lose Muk. Okay. We do get the Berserk boost, which isn't gonna do anything for us if we can't even survive a Dragon Claw. If an Earthquake did that much to us, we're more than likely going down to the Dragon Claw. And he's gonna set up in my face! Oh my god. I need Zerk to come in. And I need him to just Dazzling Gleam their faces off. I need to get this kill on Dragonite. And I have to take out the scissor too. I think my best bet is to double down and to I'm gonna get the Draco off in Dragonite, and I'm going to Dazzling Gleam. And if we lose either of the Pokemon, we're screwed. We're gonna get the Dazzling Gleam off. We are gonna pick up the kill on Dragonite. We're gonna get a Beast Boost. And we're gonna go up against a Garchomp more than likely. We're gonna take a Fury Cutter on Zerk. We're just gonna use Zerk to a freaking Fury Cutter. We're gonna get the Draco on Scizor. Oh my god, we have the plays, guys. We have the plays. So right now, he only has one other Pokemon that is not a Dragon type, I believe. I can be completely wrong. But I think we can, if it's a Dragon, he has two dragons. I think we can. He's gonna bring Salazzle, a shiny Salazzle. That's cool. And he's gonna bring Garchomp. So I think he does have Air Balloon. So my best bet at this point is basically to Draco into Garchomp, and to Ice Beam into Garchomp. Or actually, I feel like I need to slack off. So I think I'm just gonna slack off because I'm gonna need him. It's gonna be big. He's gonna Dragon Claw into Drompa. Drompa's gonna go down more than likely, and he does. So he does go down. We're gonna lose again more than likely. We're gonna take a Sludge Wave to the face. He's actually not gonna get the kill. We're gonna get the slack off up. And so basically, right now, we can hope for the one shot Ice Beam onto Garchomp, but then we have to take care of Salazzle, which I'm pretty afraid of. But we are just gonna go for the Garchomp. I should pick up the kill. He's gonna Shadow Claw. Oh my god. We are gonna tank that. Slyla. Yeah. Was that the kill? Oh, he actually lived. Do we at least get the kill on Garchomp? We do. And we'll go down to, we're gonna go down to Salazzle here. I'm so scared right now. The only way I win this, the only way, is if he misses an attack and I get a slack off up. Because I could scald, but there is a chance that he just doesn't die. This is my only chance. I just click slack off. I don't want to lose two in a row. I don't want to lose two in a row. He's gonna get the dragon pulls off, and we're gonna die. Okay, guys, I'm gonna figure out the stupid standings and how all of this works. We almost came back there, but we weren't gonna win that at that point. I am gonna find out what's up with the standings, and I will be back for the third video, or for the third battle. This has actually just been great. So there hasn't been video for this battle either. And so that sucks. So more editing for me. I'm gonna figure out what's up, and I will get back to you guys.
All right, guys. So I guess I was wording it wrong. We have done 29 games now, and we are 11 and 18 now. I was saying we were 11 and 18 before last game, but we're actually 11 and 18 right now. This team. It's definitely tricky because I'm seeing all three starters here. He's already set. He already has his mind made up about what he wants to do. I think I'm seeing Primarina and Coco. Maybe not Incineroar, but Drompa and maybe Typhon. I'm seeing Typhnole again. Could get heal blocked again. But right now, I'm thinking I could. I don't want to discharge. I think I'm safe to go with maybe Muk, or I could just get one shot first turn. I am gonna go with. I feel like Celesteela is really good right here. So I think I will bring Celesteela up front, Zerk, and we're just gonna go with Muk. Yeah, I'm just gonna click Muk. That's probably gonna be a mistake. Now I'm thinking Incineroar, Celesteela, Muk. I could maybe EQ something. We're gonna do good. We're gonna do good. This is game 30. This is the last game of the second day. I wanna take away a win right here. We are gonna see Incineroar Coco. And we are gonna bring Silking Celesteela. This is a terrible start right now. This is not what we want to have out at this point. My best. We are gonna take a Flare Blitz to the face right here. But my best bet would have to be go to Scald into Incineroar and Flash Cannon into Coco. But we aren't gonna take good hits right here since we both just get walled. I feel like I could conserve Slowking at least and go with Muk. It may discharge, but I don't see it wanting to discharge into Incineroar when it could just easily Flare Blitz into Celesteela. So I think I could set up the Iron Defense, but I'm gonna go. Yeah, I'm gonna Iron Defense. Just to hopefully be able to take a second Flare Blitz, maybe, if I can eat it up. And that's if it's physical. He is going to discharge awkwardly. That's going to go into Celesteela, and I believe a Flare Blitz will actually just kill Celesteela. We are going to get paralyzed. We're going to see a Blast Burn into Celesteela, and that's definitely, yeah, that's going to take Celesteela out. That's not good, but in another sense, I think it's fine. If we degleamed, it would hit neutral into Incineroar, I believe. So I think Zerk could be a really good bet. Because I kind of need to take out Coco. If I can take out Coco, Slowking's only threat would be Decidueye. And I kind of feel like he brought the trio in Coco, maybe. Now, I could Stone Edge into Incineroar and ensure the kill, but I'm going to take my chances and P-Jab into Coco and then Dazzling Gleam.
into their side of the field. If I see an earthquake, we are basically done. We're going to get an electro ball into Muck, and that's going to hurt. Almost take us out, actually. He did get a crit, so I don't know what the difference is on that. We aren't going to get the kill. Incineroar is going to actually recharge. We're going to get this poison jab into Coco and pick up the kill on Coco. We are down Celesteela right now, but basically all he was there for would be stab damage into Coco and Giga Drain Soul, I guess. But we're going to see Titan Null come out here. I could. I don't see a Shadow Sneak killing Incineroar. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to P-Jab into type Null. And I'm going to Dazzling Gleam. I believe I attack first, unless type Null does. We are going to attack first, and we're going to get the Incineroar down. We're going to get a hit off on type Null. That does about just under 50, and we're going to take something here. We do get a beast boost. I apologize for my dog barking. Titanol is going to crush claw into Muck. That should be Muck down. We're actually going to live that, and we're going to get a poison jab into Titanol. We get the plays here. We have the plays here. So right now, he's going to send out Drompa, and he's going to take a really nice Dazzling Gleam here first turn. And basically Muck is kind of pointless right now, to be honest. He can't Shadow Sneak either of those two. But what I see happening, Muck can actually do something here. We will get the Dazzling Gleam off, and that will kill type Null. And then I believe we outspeed Drompa. So there's no point in switching out and just taking a chance here. So I am going to P-Jab into Drompa, actually. And I'm going to Dazzling Gleam. And if I have my plays correct, we are going to get the Dazzling Gleam. It's going to be type Null. And we're actually just going to pick both of them up. Zerk really did a good job right there. Definitely look forward to seeing him on the MVP slot next game, because he definitely deserved that.
We just got that sweep with Zerk. Muck did a really good job there, getting some extra damage off, but that was all Zerk. He got, I'm gonna give him all four kills. He swept that game, and I am ecstatic about that. We really needed a really, really big win right there. My dog is agreeing with me, if you guys can hear him barking. We needed a huge win, and that is what we got. And hopefully, I'm not jinxing myself here, but hopefully that's going to give us some really big drive for tomorrow's games, because I'm really needing a big day three game sweep right here, because we are coming down to it. We are 12-18 right now, and that is far from where I want to be, actually. So I'm really needing to do well on this last day of games, and we're hopefully going to do that. But other than that, I'm going to go ahead and get started on these battles. It is actually day three while we're doing this. But besides that, guys, I love you so much, and let's get hyped for day three. There will probably be another video between now and day three. Anyways, besides that, I love you guys, and bye.